think, Dick? New competition, same success? Let's hope so, because the loser gets to watch from the stands after this third-round game between the Virginia Tech Hokies and the TCU Horned Frogs.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Horned Frogs are facing very tough opposition tonight, Dick. What's the key to them winning?
The keys tonight are very simple. First of all, I look at the point guard to step up tonight and really take control of his clock. Next, reward your big man. Give him the ball down low. Get him into the game. Let him be part of the offense. And lastly, don't be passive defensively. Be the initiator and force them to do things they don't want to do offensively.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. And he'll kick it back outside.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Both teams are looking. He rejects it. And the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
High post flashes. 10 seconds showing on the shot clock. Nice move with a face up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
And the ball goes out of play. High post flasher is open. He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Basket falls despite the contact. Working around the perimeter.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Got the high pick. That's an ill-advised shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack. Flat shot usually creates momentum and opportunities.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Trying to feed the low block. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Down inside, the center handles the pass. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Looking for contact, and he scores despite the hack. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Tries for two. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got him on the low block. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'm telling you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
They go into the low block with a bucket, and he missed. He wants a three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
At some point, his team is going to have to step up and play at his level. He's carrying them right now.
Dick, not a bat, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And they're going to count it.
Determination, baby. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
You can't miss free throws, Dick. It's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football, special situations. You got to be able to execute there. You better get rid of it, Brad.
Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. Now trying to feed the low block. And he'll kick it back outside. Fakes it. Dickey really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere. The power forward handles the feed. He shoots from outside, way off target. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. That's a foul. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Turns it over. High post player flashing. He takes the shot. He gets it to fall. On the outside, number 13 receives the ball for two. Perfectly executed.
Show the replay on that.
The Horned Frogs have a special roster, which I know you're in love with, Dick.
Well, their roster is pretty special, Brad. You know why? Because of the seniors, the leaders, the dependable ones. They're so important.
This crowd will go crazy if they get a shot to go down here.
There's the trap.
Stolen. The Horned Frogs will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. Looking for the foul. He puts it in with contact and all.
Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
The skip pass is picked off. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
Two shots. Misses the first shot. Nope. He takes the board. Time to pick up the defense here now. Picked out of the air. Carson receives the pass. Had a momentary look from three-point land.
Great anticipation defensively.
On the dribble, gives it up. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play.
Patterson is animated and ready to go.
And you know what, Brad? I'm excited for him. He's putting on a performance.
He makes the shot. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go. He's got a high post flasher. Gave it up. Moving it around the perimeter. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Working it around the perimeter.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
He gets it to go.
Look at that spacing.
He unloads a three. He can't get the bucket to fall. For the bucket, up and in. work the perimeter. For two, perfectly executed. They work it around the perimeter. From left of the circle, he's money with the shot. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Carson pump fakes. Got a nice screen. Carson was a top recruit coming out of high school. Personally, I can't wait to see how he's going to develop.
I'm happy that he's played out his eligibility rather than jumping to the pros. That's what you want from your top star recruits.
He shoots from the angle. TCU are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they're putting it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
Two-for-one opportunity. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. There's a double team waiting there. Taken away. Here's a flash from the post up high. Takes the pass in the paint.
He ran his man into the screen and dropped in a beautiful bucket.
Shot clock is dead. We're going to move it around the perimeter. Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for two.
He kept his dribble and used the screen to get the nice look from inside.
Pass in the paint. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
At the end of the first half, the Horned Frogs lead by 11. If you missed the play of the half, here's another look. TCU displayed a spectacular shooting performance, Dick, in that first half.
Indeed, Brad. I predict the defense will come out and really be a lot sharper in the second half. They better be ready to play.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys.
Thanks, Aaron. With the free one. Lots of rim, but not in.
The frustration right there.
He's got the post flashing and he wants it.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
He up fakes. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Both teams looking to get things going here. The point guard gets the pass. Picked off. He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
The Horned Frogs have a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Take some pride on the defensive end.
It's stolen. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way. He may be in trouble here, Brad.
Scorches the net. Dumps it in. Pump fakes. There they come with a double team to stop it. For the bucket.
I love the sky hook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
Now they work it around the perimeter. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
They'll work it around the arc. This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level.
Take the shot. Off the rim and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Takes away the pass. The point guard gets the ball. On the outside, he puts up the tray. Way off target. Looking for a good shot. The center with the ball. He's got a nice shot fake. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Puts it up looking for contact.
Dump it inside.
Puts it up. Off the rim and no good. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stop before any further damage is done. Guys?
Now the high screen. Way off target.
Spacing.
The shooting guard takes the pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He comes up empty. The point guard takes the feed. Tries for two. Basket falls despite the contact. He makes a nice shot fake. Gave it up. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad. They're going to find a way to get some easy buckets to get their confidence back, Brad.
Absolutely. They got to get it going here. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
The ball goes out of bounds. Sure, that's who you want shooting the three.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
definitely a foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Great defense. They work it around the perimeter. Trying to draw the foul. And he scores despite the hack. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
There's a very tight lid on that rim for him right now, Dick.
That's right, Brad. Nothing seems to be dropping.
Gave it up. For the bucket. Drops the bucket despite the harm. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Gave it up. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
He throws it up from downtown. He gets it to fall. On the dribble, gives it up. He dials long distance. Oh, yes! The ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
That was a definite blow to one team's composure. Let's see how or if this will affect the team. Pulls the trigger. Not there. Cross court. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. They're working around the perimeter.
High post screen.
He shoots from long range. Takes the rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Momentary look from three-point land. Takes it off him.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle. Was locking on the box. High post screen. Going to use it.
He drains the shot. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
Gave it up. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Checks in off the pine for his first action.
Hey, this guy will tear it up if you let him, Brad.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the front end of the 1-1. It's the second shot. We've got a timeout. Dick and I'll be back in a moment.
That's a good TO, baby.
Well, decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now. Up and inside.
He fires away. Sinks the shot. Shot clock is dead. Hard foul. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Up and in. Gets the second shot.
It's all about scoring here if they want a chance at winning.
Dick's six-point lead here.
They have to keep applying the pressure if they want to win this one, Brad.
He can't get the hoop to fall. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnover.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love that. They're not getting it done from the free throw line tonight, Dick.
It always seems like these close games, Brad, come down to free throw shooting. Let's see how this poor display affects them. People shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
TCU just wanted it a little bit more in this game, and because of that, they're going to live to play another day, Dick.
Hey, they're on their way to the Elite Eight, Mr. Nestler, where they'll be joined by the seven best teams in the nation.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler saying so long.